Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. Today's episode will begin by looking at a few SpaceX updates, then we'll have a look at various things in Boca Chica. Plus we have bits and pieces of Starships, a little SN5, SN6 and SN7 with some upcoming testing. Let's head straight in and get up to date. To begin with, there is a new article from rideshare and mission management company Spaceflight. It mentions how the company has signed an agreement with SpaceX for future rideshare missions. Apparently, the agreement will help as it secures Spaceflight capacity to launch manifest payloads on several SpaceX launches through the end of 2021. The article also says the agreement will help with providing launch schedule assurance to SmallSat customers needing frequent, reliable and cost-effective launches to sun-synchronous orbit. SpaceX responded to a tweet from Spaceflight about booking a ride on one of their SpaceX rideshare missions. SpaceX said, "More than 100 spacecraft have signed up to fly on Falcon 9 since we launched the rideshare program." In a previous video, we took a brief look at a tweet about a change to the commercial crew program. So we already knew that SpaceX had been granted permission to reuse Dragon and Falcon 9 vehicles. However, a new article from Space News has more information. Apparently, Boeing had previously been allowed to refurbish and reuse their Starliner capsule. Whilst NASA hinted last year at SpaceX also being able to do this, it's only just been added as a modification. Also, apparently the reuses could begin as soon as next year. There is a new tweet from Michael Baylor about something the former NASA spaceflight chief said. Kathy Luders apparently said, "The Crew Dragon has been doing great. Each week it wakes up and we do checkouts and then it goes back into sleep mode. The crew on orbit has also been putting it through its paces, about to do a demonstration with four crew members in the vehicle at once." Apparently, a Gulfstream jet is scheduled for a DM2 direct return mission in August to return the Demo 2 crew to Houston. So looks like NASA are planning for a return of Bob and Doug around August 15th to August 17th. The tweet from Thomas Burghardt says, "Dragon Endeavour's splashdown off the coast of Florida should then occur on or just before those dates." Along with Chris Gebhardt's tweet, which says, "A landing of Endeavour in this range would place the first regular Crew 1 long duration mission of commercial crew at no earlier than mid-September 2020. With the SpaceX updates covered, we'll now head over to Boca Chica. As usual, there has been all sorts of activity recently, starting with a new pet that SpaceX has got. As you saw last episode, there is a new doghouse for Zeus, and as people commented on my last video, Zeus is not a conventional dog. Instead, he is a Boston Dynamics spot robot, and my guess would be that he'll be used for inspecting vehicles. On the Boston Dynamics website, it says Spot has an industry track record in remote operation and autonomous sensing. In the last video, we also saw a new structure being built over near the fuel farm. As you can see here, workers are progressing with it, but still not sure what it might be. Also, over at the Starship Super Heavy launch pad, further work has been happening with the foundations. I know barely anything about construction, but believe they are pouring concrete here. In my last video, we also saw some components for a new big crane had arrived. Here you can see that workers have begun to construct this new vehicle. Apparently, this crane is a Manitowoc 18,000 and can hold a load of around 600 tons. After some reading, its reach capabilities vary from 36.5 meters up to 185 meters depending on how the crane is rigged. So I believe this could potentially lift Starship high enough to stack with Super Heavy, so this thing will be massive. Something this could be used for is the Super Heavy high bay or lifting Starship onto the launch stand. Also, I want to show you a view which has been very common in my recent videos, the next test stand. Something interesting to note is how much more complex this looks compared with the old one. Most notably, I don't think there's ever been railings at the top of the stand. Next, we have a little bit of Raptor testing information from Elon Musk. Somebody called Reagan, who lives close enough to hear engine tests in McGregor, tweeted about a recent Raptor test. She asked, "What levels are they now reaching and what are you working towards?" With Musk responding to say, "Reaching chamber pressure of 300 atmospheres. Now we'll take a look at some Starship pieces spotted here and there. First up, as you can see, we have Cory's Tucko Dome, the interesting section that will never see flight. I don't know what exactly it's for, but it's been moved outside again. Also, at another angle, you can see that a doorway has been cut out of the side. Inside the tent in the background, you can see there is a little Starship section. Last episode, we saw a tweet where Musk mentioned another SN7 tank will follow shortly. This could be part of that, but could also be for the next Starship SN version. Not sure if there will be a full-size SN7 tank or if we might see SN8 after SN5 and 6. You can also see that another new section was spotted in another tent. You can see the name Juan on the top ring for the stack, no idea who that is of course, but that's the name I'm giving to this section. Also, the Juan ring stack was recently moved outside the tent and into the yard. I'm guessing soon we could see a new vehicle using this stack, maybe the SN7 test tank. At some point in a previous video, we saw a new section that sort of looked like a bulkhead or a nose cone piece. It has been spotted again and is definitely not a nose cone section and is apparently a new thrust puck. Definitely quite a bit different to what we've seen so far. The only SN5 and SN6 to really show this episode is this amazing view. Both of the vehicles were spotted sharing the high bay together. On the left you've got SN6 and on the right you've got SN5, and wow, seeing this sight is so cool. Before we see some dates for upcoming testing, let's take a bit of a look at the SN7 test tank. As you will know, SpaceX recently tested the new 304L stainless steel in a pressure test of the SN7 bopper. You can see here that engineers have been working on it to prepare it for further testing. They've been seen lifting and installing a new vent system for the top of the vehicle. As you can see here, this has two vents, not sure why, but they're going to be testing this tank again soon. I'm going to guess that they're going to try and reach a higher pressure than the 7.6 bar it reached the other day. Not sure if this still means that there will be a second test tank to follow, but we'll just have to wait and see. However, for now, there are some road and beach closures from Cameron County for testing. With nothing happening on June 19th, the next testing dates are Monday, June 22nd and Wednesday, June 23rd. You can see an image tweeted by Michael Baylor with testing dates. The primary closure is June 24th with backup dates of June 25th and June 26th. It says these dates are for SN5 proof testing. So in the next few days, we could see another SN7 test as well as SN5 rollout. Then over the next week, there might be a whole bunch of testing taking place. Very exciting stuff is happening right now and I can't wait. Now we've reached a part of the video where I thank Mary Boca Chica Girl for her time and effort documenting history. Also, thank you to the rest of the NASA spaceflight team for their incredible work sharing these awesome insights. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.